Welcome to the February edition of the POG Show, the Port Orange City's government podcast for news and information, everything Port Orange related. And today I am joined by Deputy Chief Joe Mieske and Lieutenant Jalen Nutelski, talking to us about a charity pumper pool event that is coming up later this month over on February 17th. Welcome, gentlemen.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
Good morning.
And we are going to be doing, so this is a charity pumper pool event we have coming up later this month for one of our former firefighters, right? Craig Morrisey. Chief Mieske, can you tell me a little bit about Craig? Because he was here with the department for a little bit. He was 29 years old or so.
Yeah, Craig was 29 years old when he passed away from cancer. Oh, I'm sorry. He was 29 years old when he passed away from cancer. He worked with us for about 10 years, I believe, and worked his way up to driver engineer. Craig's father worked for us and retired from Port Orange Fire Rescue as well. So he's a legacy employee. Great guy, avid fisherman, excellent fisherman, would win tournaments, inshore for tournaments, and avid outdoorsman. And unfortunately, we lost him too young. And he's a legacy employee here. Fire Station 71 is named after him. And we're still keeping contact with his father, and they do a little get-together every year in his remembrance just to honor him each year. And this event is going to do the same thing.
What do you remember most about Craig just with his time with the department?
Well, he was the type of firefighter you'd want on your crew. He was the guy who was a go-getter. He loved the job. He loved being a part of this organization. He grew up with this organization. I remember him coming to the stations with his dad, you know, as a kid, and then becoming an employee here and becoming a firefighter with us and becoming one of our best and excellent employee. And when he became a driver engineer, he was basically one of the best driver engineers we ever had. He did his job perfectly every time. And he was always working hard to be better.
You were mentioning his father was a firefighter too. You know, he grew up around the guys at the station there. So this was kind of in his blood, a kind of his destiny to be a firefighter here in Port Orange.
Absolutely. And his father, when I came on, trained me to be a driver engineer. I got my best driver engineer training from his dad, Butch Morrisey, who worked for us for a full career and retired here. Yeah, he was another great guy, just that type of personality, just runs in the family. And they have a wonderful family, and we miss them a lot.
I mean, you got that strong brotherhood, too, in the firefighting department there. So it must have been a huge loss when Craig passed away, especially so young at 29 years old there.
Absolutely. It was a shock to everybody just, you know, to get that news that he was even sick, because he was athletic, outdoorsman, just really loved that kind of stuff. And it just seemed impossible that that could come to an end so quickly.
And, you know, even though he's gone, he's definitely not forgotten. And, you know, Jalen, you were telling me that you now are going to be honoring his memory here with this first pumper pull for Craig that we're going to be doing coming up on February 17th. Tell me a little bit about what is it for people that don't know, what is a pumper pull event? How does this all work?
So a pumper pull event, we're going to be having teams of 10. They'll be pulling the truck for time. So basically they're going to pull it 75 feet. And then basically whoever gets in first wins it. And so a pumper is just a traditional fire truck that you see rolling around town. It's not going to be a ladder truck. So it weighs about 20 tons that they're going to be trying to pull 75 feet. So those teams of 10 then really make the pull that truck, make it work.
Have you ever done a pumper pull yourself?
Yes, I did. Deland Professional Firefighters Association, they do them yearly as well. I did one 2 years ago, and it's definitely a teamwork event. And just the atmosphere alone is amazing. Just seeing all the groups of people come, all different departments, anyone, different walks of life and everything come out there for these events. And it's an awesome time.
Just for people who haven't done the pumper pull before, like, what is the mindset that you have to, you know, pull this truck that 75 feet that weighs tons?
Just everyone works as a team, get into that mindset of, I just got to get this thing across that line. And you just basically blank everything else out. Like anybody that was competitive in sports, like you would always hear like the cheering. And then once you got into that zone, it's almost like quiet and you're just going at it.
Is there a little bit of crossover from what you do as a firefighter too? Because I'm sure when you go to some of those scenes there, you kind of have to just have that tunnel vision and focus on what you're doing. Is it similar to that here, kind of working together with your team to focus on the task at hand?
I want to really say tunnel vision, because you have to take everything in as you're doing the job. Because if you get tunnel vision, you could get seriously hurt. but it's like the adrenaline dump happens and like you're like basically just ready to go and everyone's like screaming, let's go, let's go, let's go. You as a team, just the environment like gets you into that mindset of getting ready to go.
And how can people sign up if they're interested in doing this?
So if you follow our Facebook page on the union's Facebook page, we have a JOT form link and that'll take you right to the sign up for it. And you just fill it in and it gets emailed to the pumper pool group. And then you can come to the event also and sign up there.
And what's the name of the page if people want to find that on?
It's the Port Orange Professional Firefighters Union page, 3118 Facebook.
And so this will be February 17th, 3 to 7 p.m. Yep. over here at City Center.
Yep.
There's plenty of spots still available for people to sign up, even sponsors too.
Yep. We are doing some sponsors. We're going to have a banner up. So if you want to sponsor event, you could do that. And we'll get your name and logo onto the banner. And also, if you just want to come down and donate to the YES organization, they are going to have a tent set up for that as well. We're going to be having t-shirt sales. We're going to have food trucks. We're going to have a bounce house for the kids. The rec center has their new park or a new playground that's open and available. So it's going to be a good time. And then we're going to have an after party at Hooligans.
Awesome. And you mentioned the charity that's going to benefit from this is YES. And yep. They're going to be receiving some of the funds that come through with this event here. And Chief Mieske, can tell me a little bit about YES and kind of what this charity is all about and how they give back to our community here in Volusia County.
So YES stands for Youth Emotional Support, and the nonprofit, it's a nonprofit, and it was developed in 2019 with my wife and my daughter. My daughter struggled with mental health, and she wanted to do something just locally for the community. So what they did initially was they created these wellness bags, and they gave out to people who might be dealing with mental health issues. And those bags contained, you know, different types of items for, you know, for your mental health and wellness, some like sleep masks and, you know, the fidget spinner type things and different things, coloring books, things you could do to kind of relieve that anxiety and any mental health issues. So it was a very basic idea to begin with, but it was my daughter's idea. They ran with it and started handing out these bags in 2019. My daughter passed away in 2021. And as a result of these mental health issues, and we spent a lot of money, basically everything we had to send her to therapy, and we had to go to Boston to find that therapy. It's called DBT, Dialectical Behavioral Therapy. So in order to get her the treatment she needed, we did that, and ultimately the end result was not what we were looking for, but we kind of came back into COVID and backtracked, and that was the biggest problem there. So the charity or the nonprofit at that point kind of changed their mission to be more focused on how do we now help people that are going through the same thing and deal with the stigma of mental health or mental illness in this area and the lack of mental health care in the area. And, you know, it's six figures to go to McLean Hospital in Boston to have that treatment. So they thought, how can we get people to McLean? You know, we're kind of brainstorming ideas, and you'd raise money all year to send one person to get help up there. So the focus changed towards training therapists here because this area was basically a desert for that type of therapy. And since then, you know, the organization has kind of generated donations based on that and started training therapists locally in this type of therapy. And so far they've trained 40 mental health therapists. They spent $45,000 or so last year doing that. They're involved with now training coaches in the athletic. So they went to Embry-Riddle and started training their coaches in mental health areas. And they're going to expand on that because I don't know if you've heard, but there's been a lot of college-level athletes that have committed suicide over the past years. So they're trying to reach out into those areas too and just help the area kind of learn to deal with and talk about mental illness a lot more and handle the stigma of that.
And if people want to learn more about YES or how to donate or even volunteer, how can they do that?
YES2Help.org is the website, so they could go there and donate. There's charity events like the Pumper Pull here that you can come to and do it that way. But the website's the main way, and you can contact anybody from the organization that way as well.
All right. Gentlemen, anything else you want to say or get across about this event we have coming up February 17th from 3 to 7 right here at City Center?
I'd like to say it's a great idea. We've heard about these events in other locations. I'm excited that the union is now bringing that to Port Orange. I think it's going to be a great first-time event that's going to result in this being an annual event. So come on out, join the fun. You don't have to pull a fire truck to enjoy it. They're going to have bounce houses and a bunch of other things, Kona Ice, and the rec's going to be open in the indoor playground for kids. So come on out, enjoy the weather, and watch the teams pull a pumper if you don't want to do it yourself.
All right. Well, thank you, gentlemen, both. And Mick, take us on out.